Okay, I did hit start, right? Yeah. Okay, I did. Okay, so I thought I would do one more thing just to kind of dress this thing up a little bit better. Okay, so right now we have... Oh, I think I possibly disabled that. We'll see. I changed the name of this just so it's a little more clear, right? Because we can create a room by name, or you can just join and create a random. And I just changed the... Why is my... Well, apparently I lost my controller. Okay, well, let's stick that back on. I was looking at some of this logic earlier, so... Character. Simple move. Alright, so... This is kind of where we're at, right? Right, I can put in a name, okay, we've connected to the master, we can join, create a room, and we have this kind of thing so far. So I wanted to do some alterations to that. Right, so first thing we should probably alter is I'm going to add an animator. I don't know where I should make a folder, I suppose. And I'll spell shit all fucked up. So we'll call this maybe the player. Go to the player and we'll stuff that in there. And it needs some stuff. And I happen to brought in just some simple things here. So let's do one of them. And now let's do. Doesn't really matter, I suppose. Bring in one of them. Locomotion. Let's crouch. And we have a forward. I need an idle. Idle.
Whether you mix French's ketchup in with your mac and cheese,
where is my idols?
Squeeze some right on top. You can always count on French's for flavor.
That'll work.
Grown right here by Canadian farmers.
All
right,
so okay, first of all, this one needs to be a default. So, what do we have? Okay, I'm gonna use a bool for movement. Usually not my preferred method. I usually do blend trees. So we'll say is move. And we're gonna go here and there. And we have a getting hit high, so I'm gonna use probably use a trigger. Triggers aren't the best thing to use for the multiplayer. You're kind of better off with fools, but okay. And we have on our attack. I'm gonna do that from here as well. Okay, so if we get the attack, we go up there. If we get a hit, we go up there. The other thing I want to do is I want this to be pretty snappy. I want this one to be extremely snappy. These two is fine. Okay, so we have the attack, the hit. This is move is true. Take off the exit time. Take off exit time. Is move is false. All right, pretty simple. Well, let's go into the move and this is why I had this gone. I'll get rid of that. And I'm gonna get this thing called vector length. Right, so if we get the length, and that's kind of it's kind of like a normalized thing. You can store it into anything, right? Something like that, right? Every frame. And then float compare. So what this more or less is stating is if I am not touching any direction, then the length should be zero. Right, so if we're greater than that, we want to go, you know, we're going to be moving. Right? And if I copy this whole state, paste it here, and do that same thing, only now, instead of move, if we are less than that, we have stopped. So let's get rid of this. Right? Which, so over here, I mean, you don't need the character controller because we're not going to be moving anyways, technically. You might still want to add it and just give it a zero for the vector. But, potato, potato, I suppose. Right, so... just so you can, so okay, so ultimately if I'm hitting any direction, doesn't matter what direction, up, down, left, right, whatever, anywhere, using any joystick, if the length is how far it goes, so when you're dealing with axes, you're typically going from negative 1 to 1 on an axis, say left to right or up and down, so the length is 0 to 1, so if you're going to the right, then it's going to be more or less equal to that 0 to 1. But if you go to the negative side, like on the left, you're going from 0 to negative 1, the length still goes 0 to 1. Because at the max press, you're still doing the full length of the vector. I don't know if that makes any sense. But we shall see. So we have that. Now, we also need in ours, we need a animator view, or else you aren't going to sync anything, which we want is move. Like I said, triggers aren't, they work, they're not the best thing to use. We really don't need the weights. Now we have to refine it. We've got to make sure that this is linked up. Okay, and the other thing we want to make sure is make sure this is off. The root motion. I mean, if you want to use root motion, you know, fly at it. It's kind of a little bit of a different setup. So we should now have, you know, we have an animator. I guess I never did tell the animator to actually play though. So let's do that real quick. So what is the difference between here? We want set animator bool. Because we want is move is true. Copy, and we'll put it also in this one, but obviously in this one it's a little different. It's now false. Right, okay, so now let's do that. Now, I don't have the turning or anything in there, so it's going to look a little silly, I guess, but, right, because he's playing the animation whether I'm hitting left or right, or, but it's based on if there's any kind of direction right now, he's going to be playing an animation. Now, that's obviously a very silly way to kind of set this up. You would normally, okay, if you're going this way, you might want to obviously do a strafe or turn, you know, turn face that way, right? I could add that in real quick too, really. Where is that? Where is that a movement? It's over here. Smooth. Look at direction. We want to move, we want to look at that. Let's just crank it right up for now. We don't want it to finish. That space world. Not, I mean, still not the best way to set that up, but it will. Right. It's weird being in the world space with this, but very weird control, but whatever, it worked. The point is, it's there. So what do we want? Let's alter. Okay, and over here we have this, and we create a bullet. Let's get rid of that. Let's set animator trigger. The attack, and let's give it a weight. We'll say half a second. Tell it to actually go. I'm going to make a new FSM just to handle the actual attacking of this. I'll just call it that. You know, let's make an event. Call it that for now. Alright, so in the attack, we've hit that. We go over here, we're going to send an event. So we're just going to send an event to ourselves. There's a million different ways to set this thing up. So we're just going to say attacking, copy, paste. Let's give that, a second, so we can't just spam our attacks. So then over here, okay, so what I'll do, I'm going to create a cube. We're just going to use this as kind of more of a hitbox or an attacking trigger box. And I'm just going to turn that whole cube right off. So if we get this event, what we want to do is we want to activate our box that I just dragged into the variables there. We want to activate that. And then we want to trigger event. And the owner is that same box, because our player doesn't have the trigger on them, the box does. We'll look for on trigger enter, glider tag player. You know, when we hit, we need to know what we hit. And then the other thing I want to do is I want to do a wait. Because if you attack and you don't hit nothing, then we need something to happen. We don't want to leave this, our box turned on, right? More or less, because then we can attack and then run into something and we'll still do damage. So we want to turn it off. So when it gets it, we flick it on. We're going to wait half a second and then we're going to go here. But if we hit something, then again, we're still going to be turning it off. So we can almost head back down here after, right? But we have another thing that we can do is we can, for example, get ID. Of the hit object. We hit that ID. And then let's broadcast to the player. Let's go by user ID. The user ID is the hit ID. And we can send some data. We don't have to send data. We can send damage or something. And we'll use our damage event. and then we turn it off, and that's it. Okay, so let's go up to our little health here. So up here we have where we get all this event info. We're doing all sorts of fun stuff. I am going to just disable this for now by getting rid of that. So here we have this event. So we're broadcasting it to this player. So if we receive, we would set animator trigger, and you would probably, you know, reduce health or something. I'm not going to worry about that right now. All right, so let's just give this a quick little whirl. Do a little build. There we go. Hit play. Go into this one. Okay, we got person A. They've created. We have person B. And they can join. So they come stand over here. And this guy. So let's see what's happening. And as you can see over here, like the animations are playing, the rotations are playing. All right. So let's check that. Might have a trigger issue. Probably the most common thing. So let's go down in here. Oh, okay, so it's sent. So it gets, it sees it, it sees the ID. We send the event. Oh, you know what? We never. Oh no, I did sync that. Is move is halt. Alright, so we need to test something here. Let's go to our health. Let's pop that up. So this guy should be able to hit us back. And that's not happening. So what did I do down here? Did I send the event? I get it, and I broadcast all damage, which should hit that. So it's not doing it. So let's just say, let's just try normal broadcast. The broadcast two player should work though. RPC all target, exclude self, do damage. Right, so now they're both getting hit. We don't want that. Right, but we know it's at least getting sent. So we want, by user ID, we get the ID. Let's make sure that's the right ID. Where is our animator? 101. It's 2001. Okay. Hit object. It's 101. Wait a minute. Oh yeah, no, that's right. That's the right guy. I was thinking maybe my collider was hitting myself. So that is, you know what? Let's just use owned object. Hit object. We don't even need to get that then. Let's get into here and change that by here. For whatever reason, it wants to throw errors. So let's get rid of that. Change that by add object. Editing field player object reference set to an instance of an object. Yeah, but that's fine. Now, maybe that's not a good way. Unless that user ID is. I just literally had this working too. All right, let's. You know what? This should work. So here we have a hit object by owned object, use owner. Why is that not a? I don't know why that says that. Error editing field player. Object reference not set to an instance of an object. No, of course it's not. That's silly. And that is all right. You know what? Let's see this again. Let's just test that again. I don't know why I got some stupid error in there now. I tested this earlier and it worked just fine. I didn't have an error. So we will see. So we have this guy, and we have this guy. I join. Okay, well there it works. All right, well now it shows that I have an error, but it's kind of a dumb error. I think I'm actually getting close enough to hit. I don't have the greatest, oh man, this movement's so messed up. Right. Right, but there you see, like it's we're using the how do you call that thing? All right, so this is our player. So. And I move this into an FSM just to kind of try to keep things clear, right? But I mean, really, all we have is an attack, and I'm just doing the animation. I'm not doing anything else. There's nothing special about that. Other than at the beginning, I'm making sure that this is our photon. And there's probably better ways to go about that. You probably have these disabled and have like a main one, just turn them all on. So it sends an event to this, right? So all we're doing is I'm turning on my hit collider, this guy here. And that's just a simple way to do a hit collider. There's nothing special about it. We're doing a trigger event on that hit collider, right? You gotta make sure this isn't the player. If you put it to the player, it ain't gonna work, right? And then we have that small delay, because if you don't run this, and you don't hit something, this stays active, and then when you walk into the player, it does the damage all of a sudden. You don't want that. So we're just going to turn it on, and then we're going to turn it off. You give it a half a second. But while it's on, and this has an error, and when I did this earlier, it didn't have this error, so I don't know what the hell that's about. But it's working, so I'm not worried about it. Something with the GUI. I'm not worried about. Right, so we hit a player, and I'm using the send event to that player, and we're going to send damage. And if we look on here, we're just using that. Just a simple that. So this system also works. It can be a little more dependable, but it does take up some data that you might want to use for some other things. So this way can work. But that's, like I said, that's why I kind of split it. This part here is just to help straighten all that out. Okay, so this player's attacking. This is what we want to do. We want to send it off to the proper player. We're going to use this player to hit. And I would imagine if you look under the hood on this one probably does the is mine thing on all the clients, and then fires off the event. More or less, so it's probably doing more or less this same logic, but under the hood, so you don't see it. Where on this version, you just fire the event and pretend like things are normal, right? A little bit of a delay there, but that's the trigger. I mean, you have to adjust times and stuff, but it's there. It works, right? I'm not subtracting any health or anything right now, but I thought I would show that. I wouldn't recommend setting up the controls like this though. It feels so weird because it's on a world axis. So make sure you have this thing on here, or else you're not going to sync anything. And when you have it on here, make sure that it gets stuck into your photon view, right? You want to make sure the photon view is observing that. And then everything else, and then it'll give you your options, right? So you want these on. You might not need them continuous. I think discrete's more of if it changes, then send the data over. If it doesn't change, then don't bother sending that data over. So in some cases, it's fine to not run it. Let's see. And if I run this guy, I mean, he's... Yeah, I mean, it's probably don't need it continuous. I think discrete for things like that would probably be fine for the most part. But anyways, that's kind of how I would set up, you know, a little bit of the animations and like a way to damage or do whatever to the other person using hitboxes, right? If you're doing raycast, it's a completely different story. Now, you could still use this same thing, but you would have a raycast from a spot going, hitting a target, right? Like in this way, I'm using this to acquire a target. If I was to use a ray cast, which is totally doable, don't get me wrong, you would fire the ray cast, you'd figure out your directions or whatever you're doing, right? Direction self, and you know, we want to store our hit object through our ray cast and then do that same thing. But we've acquired it through ray cast now. Now obviously you wouldn't run ray cast and trigger at the same time, that's silly. In most cases. But anyways, there's a little more on some pun stuff. We'll talk to you guys later. All right.